Does Viagra make you blind? Lots of comments about this on my videos about Viagra and Cialis, and lots of uncertainties around this issue. So let's straighten this one out. When to be careful and when not. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, one of the most copied urologists on YouTube. My mission, to empower men to live 10 years longer. A healthy life will do that for you, and in my videos, I show you how to accomplish that. If you don't want to miss it, subscribe. Okay, so eyesight is extremely precious. Any rumor of something happening to your eyes will stop you doing whatever is supposed to damage them. Masturbation may be the exception, just kidding. But especially medication has a bad reputation. But let's separate fact from fiction with data, not fear. Now, why are we even talking about eyes when these drugs are prescribed for erectile dysfunction? Because medications like Viagra, Cialis, or Levitra, what we call PDE5 inhibitors, don't just affect the blood flow in the penis, they can also influence other tissues, including your eyes. In clinical trials with sildenafil, about 3% of men reported what was called abnormal vision, compared to 0% in the placebo group. In post-marketing surveillance, the FDA database showed higher rates, up to 9.5% for sildenafil and 9.3% for vardenafil. The most common effect is something called blue vision or cyanopsia, as if you're looking through light blue sunglasses. Other men notice they are more sensitive to light or that their sight gets mildly blurry. The mechanism is clear. Sildenafil and vardenafil also act a little bit on another enzyme, PDE6, which is crucial in the retina. That's why avanafil, which is far more selective, shows almost no visual side effects in clinical trials. Here's the key point. These common changes are harmless and temporary. They appear within 1 to 2 hours of taking the medication and fade as the drug leaves your system, usually in 4 to 6 hours. It's noticeable, but not dangerous, and it's been consistently shown to be self-limiting across all controlled studies. And here's a clinical observation. I have prescribed these drugs for decades. I was expecting a lot more men to report changes in their vision, but that didn't happen. In thousands of men I've treated, I can only recall about 5 who ever mentioned that they saw a bluish tint. However, let's move to the serious risks, the ones that fuel the headlines and the worried comments online. Here, we're talking about rare conditions like NAION, which stands for non-adiritic anterior ischemic optic neuropathy, essentially a stroke of the optic nerve, and retinal problems such as vein occlusions or serous retinal detachments. Let me stress the word rare. If there's something I learned during my first 10 years of a doctor, it's about the meaning of the word rare. To my surprise, I found out over time that it actually means rare. Young doctors and patients usually think rare means common. That's a misconception that's hard to grasp for some reason. In the general population of men over 50, NAION occurs at a background rate of about 2 to 12 cases per 100,000 men per year. Early safety analyses of sildenafil users showed a rate of 2.8 cases per 100,000 patient years, essentially the same as the background rate. But later research has been more mixed. A 2018 meta-analysis found no significant association in large cohort studies with a relative risk of 1.07, meaning basically no increased risk. Yet in smaller crossover studies, the same meta-analysis did find a signal with a relative risk of 2.2. Let me explain what relative risk means. It relates to the real-life risks. In the media, they always get it wrong. Relative risk of 2.2 means roughly double, but not double of the total risk. It's relative to the total risk, which is incredibly low. So in real life, we're talking about a super incredibilissimi low risk going to a super incredibly low risk. If you think this information is valuable, please give this video a like and hype it if you are one of the chosen, given the power to do so. Okay, more recently, a 2022 population-based cohort study of over 213,000 men did show an increased incidence, about double the risk of NAION and even higher an incidence rate ratio of 2.58 for serous retinal detachment. Still, let's put that into perspective. Doubling a very small number still leaves you with a very small number. A 2023 study on nearly 2 million men again found no consistent association, which shows how complex the data really are. Who is at higher risk? It's not every man. The risk clusters in men with pre-existing problems, diabetes, high blood pressure, heart disease, smoking, and certain eye structures like a crowded optic disc. In other words, men who already have compromised blood flow to the eye may be more vulnerable. The FDA and EMA have responded to this uncertainty by requiring warning labels since 2007. The instruction is straightforward. If you experience sudden vision loss after taking a PDE5 inhibitor, stop immediately and seek medical care. That's a precaution, not a prediction. Millions of men use these medications without ever seeing such a problem. Now, let's put it all into perspective with numbers and context. Your chance of being struck by lightning in a given year in the United States is about 1 in 1,000,000. Your chance of winning the Powerball lottery is about 1 in 300,000,000. The chance of experiencing a serious eye event from a PDE5 inhibitor is in that same ballpark of the extremely unlikely. Meanwhile, these medications have been used safely by millions of men worldwide for more than 25 years, with one of the most extensive safety records in modern pharmacology. I have prescribed them to thousands of patients myself. Have I seen temporary side effects like blue vision? Yes, occasionally. Have I ever seen a patient lose vision permanently from these drugs? No. And that's exactly what most urologists would tell you. Does this mean the risks don't exist? Of course not. It means that for the overwhelming majority of men, the benefits far outweigh the risks. Regulators have balanced these numbers for decades and consistently kept these drugs available because the data supports their safety profile. Nevertheless, here's a disclaimer. This video isn't medical advice and doesn't replace a visit to the doctor. After all, in most countries, you will need a prescription for these drugs. So if you want to use them, talk to your doctor about it. Don't order them online. There are a lot of fake pills out there as well. Did you know that? The risk of buying dangerous counterfeits is very low if you order it from a decent pharmacy, but you will need a prescription for that. Follow the prescribed dose, and if you ever notice sudden vision changes, not gradual aging or needing stronger reading glasses, but sudden, dramatic loss of vision, take that seriously and seek emergency care. So, does Viagra make you blind? The myth is busted. It can cause temporary, harmless visual changes in a minority of men. And it can very rarely be linked to serious events in men who already carry risk factors. But for the vast majority of users, the data shows it is safe. So which one is the best drug for you? Viagra or Cialis or Levitra or Stendra? If this is your burning question, watch this video. And give some digital applause for this one. Subscribe, like, and share. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, always copied, never matched.